Swadika, welcome to Be My Guest. I'm Sian Traha Nutsaha. We're here at Ratchamongkol University of Technology Thanyapuri, or RMUTT, to speak to Thailand's expert in wind energy, Assistant Professor Dr. Wirachai Roynarin, or Dr. Roy, who is also the President of the Thailand Renewable Energy for Community, or TREC. Dr. Roy is going to talk to us all about wind energy here in Thailand and how it is important to the country.
Sawadee ka.
Dr. Wirachai, thank you so much for joining us for Be My Guest. So you are an expert in renewable energy as you are the president of the Thailand Renewable Energy for Community. Can you tell us about renewable energy in general?
Actually, the renewable energy has come about 20 years ago. That is the time that I went to study for my doctorate degree in England. And in that time, renewable energy is just the part, just only the part of the energy. But in European and in some parts of state of USA, they are very famous for a long time. But in South Asia, about 25 years ago, renewable energy is just only the thing that we just start to study. And not a lot of people and students understand what is renewable energy. Actually, renewable energy is the energy that comes from the nature. Yeah, this is like from the wind, from sun, from solar power, or even in the wave energy in the ocean. This is we can differentiate between renewable energy and sustainable energy and clean technology. For generate the power like electricity. Normally, renewable energy is not all of them is sustainable energy.
Oh,
yeah,
I didn't
know sustainable
that.
Energy that is the energy that never gone, like power from the sun and power from the wind, or wave or ocean energy.
Right. Oh, so fossil fuels are not sustainable. Is
yeah,
that correct?
Fossil is the not sustainable energy. Nature, yeah, is a mode of the. Natural energy is sustainable energy, but renewable energy, the thing, if we think about renew, that means we can reuse, we can reproduce, like a palm oil, or even in a biodiesel, or some of the biomass or biogas that we can generate from the agriculture product or byproduct of agriculture, like for palm oil, from cassava or something like that. That is renewable energy. But they are not sustainable energy. That we have to differentiate, and we have to classify. What is sustainable energy? What is renewable energy? Or what is the green or clean technology?
So I'm guessing then renewable energy is more beneficial than even sustainable energy. Or sorry, sustainable energy is more beneficial than renewable energy.
That's right.
Very visionary. And I want to talk more about this. But before that, can you explain to us what are the main benefits of wind power?
The wind power is very clean. The most of the wind machine or wind turbine, what we call
wind turbine.
Wind turbine is just only engineering have to design exactly what is the wind resources. The most important thing is how to design the machine suitable for the wind resources. In European or in the state, they have a wind speed approximate about 6 to 7 meters per second. The velocity of the wind in European or in the state, that is the wind resources in European or in state.
Okay.
In the place we call very high wind speed.
Wind speed already.
Yeah.
Okay.
But in South Asia, or in 70% of the globe of the world, we have average wind speed. Even in Thailand, we have average wind speed only about 4 to 5 meters per second. That time, if people don't understand, they think that the wind machine the same. But actually, it's not the same. It's different research and different machine. In that time, I study how to design the wind machine to suitable with the wind resources in South Asia.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, that's why my topic of my doctor degree is design of low wind speed. For the wind machine in low wind speed zone. They have a lot of research in this field for low wind speed zone. Even the blade, the rotor
mm-hmm.
yeah, in the permanent generator
mm-hmm.
and some part of control all are different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have to focus in the machine that suitable for low wind speed zone.
Right, it sounds complicated, but you're making it sound much more easier. We'll talk more about this just after the break. Stay tuned for more right here from Be My Guest. Welcome back to the program. We're here with Assistant Professor Dr. Wirachai Aroinarin, President of the Thailand Renewable Energy for Community, or TREC. You're also called Dr. Roy.
Dr. Roy. Yeah.
Wow,
that's
okay.
My friend,
Dr. Roy. Fantastic. So everyone around the world knows you as Dr. Roy.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, before the break, you were talking to us about wind power and its importance, and you explained the very complicated process to us. One more question. How much energy does a wind turbine actually produce?
Actually, the wind machine in the world now mm-hmm. is maybe number one for renewable energy. Maybe they produce up to about maybe 6,000 gigawatt.
Okay.
Yeah, but in Thailand, we just start about 7 years ago
mm-hmm.
that we become very famous for renewable energy. In Thailand now, maybe we have about up to 1,000 megawatt.
Okay, this is in total.
Yeah, in total.
Okay.
Yeah. But in the program for Thailand, we have to go for the target about 3,000 megawatt.
Okay.
Yeah.
So speaking of Thailand, how did the construction of windmills or wind turbines get started here in Thailand? Why this interest in this?
Because of the comparison between the wind power and other source of renewable energy, the wind machine may be more expensive compared to the solar cell,
mm-hmm.
compared to photovoltaic, as we can see around. But wind machine take the less of land
mm-hmm.
because of the wind machine generate power from the sky.
Mm-hmm.
That means they occupy the land area very little compared mm-hmm. to the other sort of renewable energy.
Oh, solar cells take up a lot of space.
Yeah, that's right.
Right.
Compared to 1/10.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, compared to the solar cell,
mm-hmm.
but the wind machine is more expensive than solar cell for the first installation process.
Okay.
Maybe about up to 20% more expensive than the
20%.
Solar cell. Yeah, compared to megawatt. Yeah, for the power plant for 1 megawatt, mm-hmm. maybe the price is more expensive. But the most advantage of the wind machine is that they take less land. Also, when about up to 20 years next, we can sell the treasure because the column, tower, and everything is a material that's very good. You know, and we can keep for the treasure up to 30% to sell to the market because the tower still make a very good profit. The stainless steel, copper for generator, and all the things that we can sell to the market and don't have to waste energy to the environmental effect or something like that. Like a solar cell, we have to make the process to clean up after we use up to 10 or 15 years.
Oh.
Yeah, but this is the difference between a wind machine and solar cell.
Okay.
But most of people think wind machine is more important to generate the power because we have to save the land for agriculture, for the food.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. In Thailand, we have very less land.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That means now the wind power become more famous and mm-hmm. more important.
Mm-hmm.
And the new technology can generate very high efficiency, mm-hmm. high performance for mm-hmm. the wind machine for low wind speed zone.
So it's a better alternative.
Yeah, that's
now,
right.
I understand that the push for wind power here in Thailand was actually backed by the late monarch, His Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej.
Yeah, that's right.
Is that correct? Can you
yeah.
tell us about this?
This is my very impressive thing and very important for my life because when I was graduate about 10 years ago, mm-hmm. I got the message from the king that he want me to make the first wind farm in Thailand in King Ramanai in Phetchaburi province.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first project.
Was this the Chang Huaman project?
Yeah, Chang Huaman project. Mm-hmm. Yeah. In that time, in Chang Huaman, that place is very less of energy and no water, no electric, and all of the thing is sand and not very famous like nowadays. King want me to and my team for engineering faculty from UTT to survey and to design the first prototype the pilot project. That is become important for my life because I got the budget from the king. The king give the budget about 7 million Thai baht.
Mm.
Yeah, that is his budget and mm-hmm. his money.
His own money. Funds.
Yeah. Give to me, that is my impression. And in that time, we have about 7 engineers on my student and all of my team go to Chang Woman places in Petri. And then we decide the first wind machine, 20 units for 5 kilowatt. Each mm-hmm. wind machine, 5 kilowatt generate mm-hmm. electricity
mm-hmm.
and join together with the solar cell
mm-hmm.
and hybrid system
mm-hmm.
between wind machine and solar cell. The first project in Southeast Asia.
Fantastic.
That is from the our king, Ramanai.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Such
that
an
is very, yeah, that's very brilliant because his vision is mm-hmm. very good in renewable energy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the king of renewable energy.
Yes.
Yeah.
So aside from Chang Woman, where else can we see wind turbines here in Thailand? What other projects have you
yeah,
been doing?
Yeah, after Chang Woman project finished, about 3 years after Chang Woman project finished, then I get the message from the Thai Rue Lam Chabang.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we call the Lam Chabang port.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that they have a green port project because all over the world they want to reduce carbon dioxide for the port authorized of each country.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got they visit Chang Woman and they know that I make the wind machine for the king project. Then they asked me to make a bigger one, because the land in Lam Chabang mm-hmm. port is very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they cannot do solar cell on the land because the land is reserved for the transportation, for the storage,
mm-hmm.
and for very important for them. And then they make decision to make the wind machine. They order 10 kilowatt. That is bigger than King Farm.
Mm-hmm.
King in Chang Woman is 5 kilowatt each machine.
Mm-hmm.
In Lam Chabang port is 10 kilowatt, mm-hmm. double size.
Double the size.
Yeah, double size. And they order about 84 units because they want to give respect to the king. In that time, the king was 84 years old.
Oh, it's 84th anniversary.
Yeah, and then they want to follow the king's step. And then I'm very proud. We take about 2 years to make a new blade design,
mm-hmm.
a longer blade,
mm-hmm.
bigger generator mm-hmm. for generate electricity, make a system design and installation take about 2 years. After that, still running and very good performance because in Lam Chabang, near the coastline, near the sea, the wind very strong and steady. Yeah, in Chang Woman, near the mountain,
mm-hmm.
a lot of turbulence.
Mm-hmm.
But we learn a lot from the King Farm. We get the chance, we got a very good chance to learn an engineer student
mm-hmm.
in our Faculty of Engineering.
Mm-hmm.
Follow me to see the performance to solve the problem. We learn a lot from the King Farm, from the King Farm project. Then for the Lam Chabang port, we have a more expert. We know and we more understand of wind machine in Thailand. And we have about 100 people, labor, occupied for this project.
Mm-hmm.
And now the blade that designed by Dr. Roy, we call Dr. Roy blade, we export to Korea, to Philippines, to now the wind machine in Thailand. We also not only sell in Thailand, we export to Southeast Asia and in Asia country as well.
Dr. Roy, that's fantastic. We have to take another break.
Yeah.
Stay tuned. Our audience as well, please stay tuned for more right here from Be My Guest. Welcome back to Be My Guest. We're here with Assistant Professor Dr. Wirachai Roy Narin, the President of the Thailand Renewable Energy for Community, or TREC. Dr. Wirachai is also known as Dr. Roy around the world.
Yeah.
And you've been exporting the wind turbines here from Thailand.
Right.
So you mentioned before the break just now that we started off with a five kilowatt turbine, from the Chang Woman project that was initiated by His Late Majesty. And that grew to 10 kilowatts. And so what's the situation now in Thailand?
If we take for 10 years back mm-hmm. from beginning, we start off the King Farm project
mm-hmm.
in Rai Chang Woman.
Mm-hmm.
It's 5 kilowatt per wind machine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then we have another project in Lam Chabang port, double size.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's 10 kilowatt.
10 kilowatts.
Yeah, 10 kilowatt. then after Lam Chu Bang Port project, then our team thinking that okay, 10 kilowatt is still too small for us. Then we make decision to build another one that's a bigger size and suitable for low wind speed zone in South Asia. Mm-hmm. And we want to competitive price with the bigger size of the megawatt size of the wind machine from European, from abroad.
Mm-hmm.
And okay, for 1 megawatt, we think that we occupy the same land. And we want to decide the advantage of the low wind speed machine that they can self-start without the electricity consumption.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the wind machine, the big one that we see in Europe and in the state, they consume electricity from the starting point because the rotor is too heavy.
Okay.
It's very heavy rotor, the blade very long, about 40 meter to 60 meter blade.
Goodness.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then for the high wind speed machine, they need electricity become motor first to start the rotor from the wind very low speed.
Mm-hmm.
But for us, we want to design the blade self-start without electricity consumption.
Oh. So yeah. How far are you in this development, in this design?
Now we have one project already ordered for us for 100 kilowatt. And now the project is complete. We have the very low wind speed. They can cut in the term of engineering, we call cut in wind speed only 2.5 meter per second.
Mm-hmm.
Then the rotor can rotate by themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't have to consume electricity. That is the most benefits of our 100 kilowatt wind machine now, and we can sell to the market now.
That's
for 100 kilowatt.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Are you still the only doctor in wind power here in Thailand? Are there any other people who have gone to study in this field?
Now I think maybe about five doctor.
Okay.
Yeah, in Thailand that graduate for the wind power, and we know each other.
That's good.
Yeah,
so
but another
together.
University. Yeah.
Well, that's fantastic. But you have been here at Ratchamongkorn University of Technology, Thanyaburi, sharing your knowledge with students. Is this a big department? Are there many students studying about wind power?
Nowadays, we have three doctors
that
I am a professor, look after them. And we have the program doctor degree in energy, in renewable energy.
Mm-hmm.
But most of them, they come to study with me because they want to become my student, because they want to study about the wind machine.
Sure.
Yeah, and also now we hybrid. We make the program controller that a hybrid between wind machine and solar cell.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we call hybrid system, two sources of energy become to one.
Okay.
And then more performance and more electric generate power to the line. And the student nowadays, they're thinking about the clean technology. They're thinking about how to make the wind energy a bigger one, bigger than me. Yeah, and also they want to know how to make the wind machine more cheaper, cheaper than I do. Yeah, and because the materials nowadays very important.
Mm-hmm.
The technology from wind machine now, because of the material developed very good, then the blade is more lighter and not very heavy like my one, and also the stronger and lighter and stronger. That's what we really want. And we have the energy and material for doctor degree. That's why some students study in material, and another group of students study in wind energy.
Mm-hmm.
Then they combine knowledge, and they develop a new thing.
Well, it sounds like more and more students are realizing the importance of wind power and renewable energy here in Thailand.
Yeah.
And also, it looks like wind power will be, from what you've explained to us, wind power will be very beneficial to the country. It can create jobs. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
What kind of jobs will there be for
the
people who
the job,
work on
the
wind
job
power?
Now in Thailand, one is for making generator, for generate the electricity.
Mm-hmm.
We have the job for the making generator.
Mm-hmm.
We have the job for the blade producing the blade in Thailand.
Mm-hmm.
Then we use fiberglass.
Mm-hmm.
We use technology of carbon fiber and Kevlar and compound materials. Still need the man do, not the machine.
Not machine.
Yeah, man have to lay out the resin, had to lay out the moon and use man about 20 to 30 person in the factory that making the blade.
Mm-hmm.
And another is making the tower from the steel. Yeah, mm-hmm. that is steel factory. Mm-hmm. They employ about 10 to 20 person.
Mm-hmm.
And engineering, that's it. Most of them is my student mm-hmm. in the FT Energy mm-hmm. company
mm-hmm.
that we export to them. And they are authorized dealer from the research become to commercial.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that is the FT Energy. They are all my students. When they graduate about 10 years ago now, they become to general of, or MD of that company. Then they, we are about 20 person. Then include everyone that in my job, in my term of a wind machine now, up to about 100 person mm-hmm. involved for the wind machine and installation and maintenance, look after the machine for the next 20 years. Then we have to educate the new generation or to big and spread to around the world.
That's great. Yeah. So how does Thailand compare to other countries in Southeast Asia in terms of wind power and our ability in this field?
I think not only the renewable, not only the wind machine.
Mm-hmm.
I think Thailand could be the number one for the Southeast Asia for mm-hmm. clean technology, mm-hmm. for renewable energy.
Mm-hmm.
We have about up to 4,000 megawatt yeah, for renewable energy. That we use.
Mm.
Yeah, compared to other country, they are follow us. Yeah, mm-hmm. they have maybe only 5 or 10% of us. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for renewable energy, for the wind power, maybe only in Thailand that we are manufacturing wind machine,
mm-hmm.
and now the from Philippines, from Malaysia, they come to have a part time job with our university.
Okay.
Yeah, and they come to train. To train how to installation, how to assembly the blade and the rotor mm-hmm. in the renewable energy section
mm-hmm.
in the Faculty of Engineering. And also they become to like a sub-dealer of FT Energy that they export the wind machine to Philippines, to Malaysia, mm-hmm. then we need a subcontract.
Wow.
Yeah, now they come to Thailand to train,
okay.
to train how to installation, okay. how to maintenance, how after service. Yeah, that is we are maybe in the central of the wind machine in Southeast Asia.
That's great. So Thailand is leading the way.
Yeah.
Dr. Roy, thank you so much for speaking to us about wind power and
right.
how it's great for Thailand.
Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Khop khun
you.
Ka.
Yeah. Khop khun khap.
Wind power has certainly come a long way in Thailand since its beginning under the guidance of the vision of His Majesty the late King Bhumibol Adulyadej. And how wonderful for us to hear, as our guest just told us, that Thailand is in the forefront of the development of this energy. That's all for being my guest today. Thank you for joining us, and be sure to join us for future episodes. I'm Sian Frahan Utsaha. Sawadee ka.